scripture about stuff, about what's appropriate, what's not appropriate, huh? What about the faults of my brother and the faults that I bring to the table myself? And they said in the text, when you read that, it said this person should be fully convinced of his or her own position, listen, and participate, but not listen, to honor the Lord. It said you got to honor God no matter what your challenges are in your life. And he goes on to say, strictly, those who associate this sin with things God has not explicitly condemned are considered those that are weak in the faith. Romans 14:1, it declares that, listen, however, those who embrace their Christian freedom, listen, in that they are, listen, they are not to look down on those who are more convicted. That means, listen, that everybody may not walk the same path as it relates to what I believe and understand about the Word of God. But the encouragement that we learn to interpret the Word from the Word. Does that make sense? Let the Bible interpret the Bible itself. We're not those that, listen, give the, listen to the Scripture our personal interpretation. But let the Word declare. This is what the Word is saying.
That's right.
About who God is. Are you hearing what I'm saying? And what the Word tells us in this text, he goes on to declare, and those with more restrictive opinions, listen, it says should not unduly judge those, huh, that may not be walking where you're walking right now.
See?
Huh? Listen what the Word declares. Now, Paul writes,
what do
no
y'all
one lives or dies to themselves.
Okay.
Christians are not meant to exist in a vacuum. Why would we allow this environment, listen, to become the norm for us? Huh? When the Word said that's not even the reason or the purpose for which I made you. I'm talking about God's perspective of the clay. God made us, listen, to be social and to interact.
What do y'all see, my dear bread?
God did not intend for us to just exist in a vacuum. In fact, we cannot wall ourselves off from the Lord, nor can we wall ourselves off from other believers. We got to become those that declare, I need God. Huh? And listen, and if we were to declare what the Bible declares over us, we would even go as far as to say we need
my
each other.
Folks.
The Bible says, listen, and we overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. Is what the Word says. Now love, the end of that verse, it said, and we love not our lives even unto death. Now, y'all know we can tell the Lord. That's like when God, as I was sharing, I think, last week about the communion. When folk, when the Lord tells us something that we don't necessarily embrace or agree with wholeheartedly, we really back up on God. There's something wrong with him. Talking about we don't love, that we love not our lives even unto death. That's why folk are hiding under the bed right now. Huh? Listen, I want to encourage you, listen, that while you got to be a person that employs some wisdom as it relates to how you, listen, navigate through the season that we're in, you can't be a Christian and be scared. Huh? You got to be someone that declares, if God be for me, he's more than all the world, listen, that would ever be against me. We got to know it's easy for us to have faith. Listen, when you are hiding in a bubble someplace, listen, I come to tell you today, the only bubble you can hide in is God himself. My God, in him I live. In him I move. And in him I have my very being. You got to be someone that says, listen,
bus fan.
I will trust
in the Lord.
My God, listen, I put a mask on. I, listen, sanitize every 5 seconds when I'm riding around doing stuff. You don't know what I'm saying. But I want to tell you today, glory to God, I trust in God. And I know, listen, the sanitizer didn't save me. The mask ain't going to save me. But God, my God, is the one. My God, that saves. He's the one that keeps. He's the one that delivers. You got to grow to the place where you know that, listen, while I do the things I'm doing, my God, relative to the CDC recommendations, I, listen, have been following the recommendations of the Bible before the CDC was ever concocted. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. You got to be someone that declares, my God, if God, listen, rise up. The Bible says he is Jehovah Rapha. That means I am the Lord that healeth thee. If you're looking for gods. I come to tell you today that God is,
God is
our deliverance.
Our deliverance.
God is our healing. You got to believe that that's what God has declared over our life. You got to trust and believe and know that, listen, because God is the healer. My God, he said, I want to let you know that if you can have it, then God has the power to heal it by his blood. And I don't know about you, but the last I heard, the blood still works. Everybody in this place,
thank you, Jesus.
The blood, it still works. You want to celebrate God and give God glory.
Hallelujah. Now you see there. Y'all listen,
saints of God, and thank you for tuning into the Light to the World, the broadcast. We want to take a break here in the broadcast.
Y'all get all the information for
yourself. At New Bethel Church of God in Christ. Please go to our website
at
www.newbethelchurch.com.
There you'll discover
our order of services, our church location, events going on at the church, the many ministries we offer, the vision we embrace, and an opportunity to sow into God's kingdom. Again, that's www.newbethelchurch.com. Now let's go back to the Light of the World broadcast already in progress. Be blessed.
Be blessed.
Listen, y'all, let me go through this. Take it deeper this moment. But listen, what the Lord declares, let me hurry on. Listen, it may feel easier, y'all. Listen, I want to tell you that while there are justifiable reasons, but many of us are at home right now. Listen, you got to know that while you're there, listen, this is not the model. That God has set for us. And we should always listen to what I'm saying. Listen with great anticipation. Look for the day, listen, when we return to the house of God for the purpose of fellowship with other believers and advancing the kingdom as the Lord has destined for our lives. Listen, stay there as long as you need to stay there. But while you're there, what I'm encouraging you right now, don't let your love for God begin to wane. Don't let your desire to assemble with the saints begin to dissipate.
That's
right. I know the news is telling you there has to become a new normal. I want to let you know you got to know when to rebuke the devil and cast the devil out. You got to know when to let the enemy know if God be for us, he's more than all of the world that could ever be against us. You got to know, don't let the enemy rock you to sleep. The Bible said, be sober and be vigilant.
Yep.
For your adversary, the devil, like a roaring lion, is seeking whom he may devour. You got to be someone that declares, I'm not going out like this. I'm going to stand and declare the works of the Lord. I want God to move in my life.
Amen,
I
Jesus.
Want God to stand up in me.
Hallelujah,
as never before.
Jesus.
Is there a believer in this house? Is there a believer in the kingdom of God that's ready to tell the enemy, I will believe a word that you declare. I'm going to believe what the word of God has spoken over my life.
That's right.
My God,
he done kept us this far. Say what now?
The Bible, declaring his testimony.
That's
and
right.
He said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. He said, I ain't scared.
I ain't scared.
He said, I will fear no evil. Why am I not scared? Because thou
art with
me. I dare somebody shout, the potter is walking with me. His rod and his staff, it comforts me.
Right.
The telltale before me, the
presence
of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. And then he testified, my cup is running over. I dare somebody to struggle. Declare I'm living off the overflow. Give God praise.
Living off the overflow. Hey, ain't got it.
Glory right now. What an awesome God we serve.
Awesome.
What the Lord said. Listen, I may well be easy for us to do what we're doing, but you got to know that it may certainly not serve the personal growth model. Listen, that God determined for us from the beginning.
Hallelujah,
let me
Jesus.
Say it one more time. time. It's easier for me than my God to wake up in my bed.
Okay, y'all, the 10 minutes is on. I want to keep it rolling, but I don't want you to miss this.
That it may not fit the personal growth.
Jesus, make it happen. Make it happen, Jesus.
In the Word of God, God told us, He said to count it all joy.
Count it all joy.